Now we will learn about data type and factor. We have opened the script and I will save the script. I will save it as data type. First three line will be same, that means rm list equal to ls, so that the output will get onto the clear screen. Then I will import CSV function read dot and then view CSV1. Now I will execute these three lines and will get my original one. Now before starting data type and factor, first of all we will know that we should know in our language variables are not declared as some data type. That means variables are not as a data type, but variable in the R language is treated as an object here. It means everything in R will be treated as an object. So there are so many type of objects in the case of R. The type of objects are vector, list, matrices and data frame. Data types are data types in R, vector, list, matrix and data frame. These four are the primary data type. If we consider the vector data type, then R language has the following types of atomic vector data type. So if we talk about vector data types, then vector data type are termed as atomic vector types, and this is logical, integer, numeric, complex data type, and last one is character data type. So these are five kind of vector data type. Now we will treat one by one. So first of all, test data. Test data to true value. That means true or false value. What kind of data it is? So what is the class? Because class will tell me type of data. So test data is the variable, and let us check what kind of data. So we have seen that it is a logical kind of data. Okay. Because logic has been involved, either true or false, so it is logical data type. Now in the same manner, test data, I am declaring true in quotes class. Test data, what is test data class? So let us check it, and now it becomes as character. That means when we applied quote on true value, then it become as character data type. If only true or false has been supplied, it is logical type of class, logical data type, and if we have applied double quote, then it become as character data type. I will copy so that in place of true, if I am writing as 12, then let us check now what happens. So now it becomes as numeric. That means it is a numeric data type. It is not integer data type. It is a numeric data type. So what should be write to change it in integer data type? So we will apply L. That means in place of 12, we will write L. Then let us check the type. Now it becomes as integer. So if we apply only 12, then it is numeric data type. But when we write L in place of 12, then it becomes as integer data type. Let us take a value which is floating point number. That means 12.5. Now let us check which kind of data type. It is also numeric kind of data type, and if we apply L, then what happens? There is an error, because you cannot apply L for decimal number. Okay, you cannot apply decimal number here. Is there any other method to change a numeric data into integer type? So yes, there is method. there is method to change this. So here test data is numeric data, control enter. Now it become as numeric data type, and I want to change this numeric data type as integer data type. Then what should we do? Test data and as dot integer 12.5, and now class test data, now it become as integer. So to convert it into integer, we will write as dot integer. In this case also we can apply the same thing. That means 12 was the numeric data type, and by using the same method we can change 12 in integer format also. That means by applying L as well as by using as dot integer, we can change the data type into integer type. So these are something which numeric. In the case of complex data type also, we can write a complex number. So in that case also, this will be a complex data type. Let us write some complex number, that means 3i plus 2, it is complex number. So in this way, this will become a complex number, okay. And we know how we can write the character data type. Any name if written into double quote, it will be treated as the character data type. Now next thing which I will explain is to write a structure. So I am writing this line again, these two line even. I am writing these two line again so that we not scroll too much. So if we execute, then we get our table. Now we want to know the structure of CSE1. So str function will be applied, and CSE1. So if we'll execute this line structure, then what we get? We get the structure. That means it is a kind data frame, 5 object and 6 variables are there. So everything is treated as an object here. This is about now one more thing is factor since R. What is factor? So factor are such variable in R which take a limited number of different values. It is often referred to as categorical attribute also. Now the next thing we are going to discuss is list and its operation. So before this, first of all I will open a new script, and inside that script we will rename the script, save as list, and we'll save list here. Again the three line which we have written in the previous code, that means to clean the terminal, to read the CSV file which I have created, and view this. Now I will execute these three line by pressing Ctrl plus Enter, and in this way I have received my original data frame CSE1. So in the list R, first of all we will understand what is the list. So list is an R object, and it has different kind of mixed data types. These are string, numbers, vector and some other kind of list. So basically the definition of list, it will have different kind of data type like string, like number, like vector and some other kind of data also. So a vector having all element of the same data type is called as atomic vector, and also a vector having element of different data type is called as list. So the difference between atomic vector and list is that atomic vector will be having same kind of data type. So the analogy is like array and structure. array and structure. Just like in the C programming language, array is having same kind of data type, here the vector is having similar kind of data type and list is having different kind of data type. So, this analogy is only to remember, it does not have any fact. We will do some operation here. First of all, I will create a matrix. So, as we already know, to create a matrix, first of all, subdata, I will take the variable name as subdata as I have done previously, and here CSC1, my file here CSC1 and inside this CSC1, first of all I have to see the structure. I will construct the matrix by these three, that means I will take name as age, weight and height. So, here first to third row and create by taking age, weight and height. First one is age, weight and third one is height. I have taken these three things. In the second line, we will create a matrix A, and in this matrix we will as dot matrix function will be applied on sub data. So, in this way the matrix can be created. Let us check it. Control, okay, view is not here. To view the matrix, or print whatever we want, print matrix A, and if I execute these three line, then we get the matrix as here. Okay, so matrix has been created. Now I will take another thing, because I want to create a list, so I am creating different kind of data items so that we can encapsulate all the different data items and create a list. So, this is matrix. Now, second, I am creating a simple vector. So, my vector data type is very simple, and I simply take a number from 1 to 5. So, my vector has been created here. Okay. So, vector has been created, matrix has been created. I am going, data frame is already there, csc.csv is my data frame. Now, I am having three different kind of data type here. One is data frame, one is matrix, other is vector. So, I am going to create my list. So, my list will contain, by using list, we can create list. First one is csc1, my data frame, and after matrix, my matrix, and third one is my vector. So, these three things are there, these are my list. Now, I am executing my command, and here there is no error. So, I can understand that it successfully has been. Now, let us check my list here. I can see that there are three kind of things here in my list. First one is this one, and this is CSE1. The second element of my list is the matrix, and third element of my list is this simple vector. So, in this way we have seen that how we can create my list here. If I want to know what are the names of my list, we will create. So, first one is frame, second name is matrix, and third name is vector. Okay, third name is vector. So, in this way I can give the name of different data items. So, print, if I am giving print command to my list, then everything will be printed. Now, let us see what will be the output here. control enter. So now in the previous case no names was there, only the number of list item was there, 1, 2 and 3. Now by doing this thing, by naming different items of this list, that means CSE1 as data frame, matrix A as matrix, my vector as vector. Now we can see that when I executed the code second time, data frame, that means every kind will be specified by its distinct name, just like data frame has been written as data frame, matrix has been written as matrix, vector has been written as matrix. So this is very beautiful way how we can name different items of my list here. Again, by doing this we can do the things in the reverse order also. That means if my list, I want to know what are the data frame part of my list, so we can do this also. Data frame part of my list can be displayed like this. So this is my data frame part of the list. Likewise, we can do the other part also, my list, and the second part is matrix. So I can check this part also, so matrix part is this. So we can do the thing in the reverse order also. My list at the rate vector, what is vector part, so we can execute vector part also, and here we can see. So we can do the same thing in the reverse order also. The same thing can be done by indexing method also. Okay, what we have done here, we can do the same thing by indexing method also. That means in place of writing this thing, we can simply write my list and index number like 1. Let us see what will be the output. So we can say see that by indexing method also, the first data item in my list was data frame, and data frame has been printed out here. Likewise, by placing 2, by placing 3, we can get matrix as well as vector part of my list also. This is how we can do different operation of my list. Now the second part is merging, how we can merge different lists here. So before doing this, first of all I should create one more list so that we can show how we can merge. So my list is my first list, and now because I am showing merging, therefore I should write merging two lists. I am going to create and the list 2. This was my list, this was list 2, and inside this list 2 I will create how we have created my this list. So because it is very simple list, therefore I can directly create the list by C command, that means create command. So let us write 1, 2, 3. So this is my simple list. Let us check list 2. No need to check, I am directly merging the two list. So merged dot list, I will merge the two list by create command, and first list is my list, was my first list here, and second list is list 2. So in this way we can write the list. Now print command, I am going to give print command, and merge list should be. So let us run this some lines and let us see. So here we can see that the merge list is here. So everything has been, after printing merge list, data frame, matrix, these are the elements of my first list, and then vector of this, these three are the element of my first list, and then the fourth element of the list is 1, fifth element is 2, sixth element is 3. So in this way all the six element, 3 element from my first list and 3 element from my second list, and all the element of the list are having a distinct number. Therefore, we can say that this is now become a part of newly generated list. So, this is all about the merge list.